Watch us on YouTube and Facebook. Listen to our podcast and support us on Patreon. Thanks for stopping by.
We see the horizon of the west, or the mountain of the west, divided into two parts, and the boat of the sun is supposed to sail between them and to enter by this passage into the Tuat. On the right hand is fixed a jackal-headed standard, and on each side of it kneels a bearded god. One god is called Tat, and is a personification of the region which is beyond the day, and the other Set, and represents the funeral mountain. On the left hand is a ram-headed standard, and on each side of it also kneels a bearded god. As before, one is called Tat, and the other Set. The ram's head has the horizontal, wavy horns, which belong to the particular species of ram that was the symbol of the god Khnemu. This animal disappeared from Egypt before the 12th dynasty, but the tradition of him remained. In the middle of the scene sails the boat of the sun. The god is symbolized by a beetle within a disc, which is enveloped in the folds of a serpent having its tail in its mouth. In the bow stands the god of divine intelligence, whose name is Sa, and in the stern, near the two paddles, stands Hika, i.e., the personification of the word of power, or magical utterance. The god who usually accompanies Sa is Hu. On the right of the boat stand 12 gods, who are called gods of the mountain. On the left of the boat stand 12 gods, who are called gods of Set-Amentet. The boat of Ra, having passed between the two halves of the horizon of the west, now approaches a gateway, the door of which is closed before him. The door of the second division of the Tuat is different from the doors of the other divisions, for it consists of a single leaf which turns upon a pivot working in holes in the top and bottom of the framework of the door. This door is guarded by a serpent called Se-Set, which stands upon its tail. In the center of the scene, we see the boat of Ra being towed along by four gods standing, each of whom grasps the tow line with both hands. The god is now in the form of a ram-headed man, who holds the scepter in his right hand, and has the solar disk above his horns. He stands within a shrine which is enveloped in the voluminous folds of the serpent Mehen. A serpent also stands on his tail before him. In front of the shrine stands Sa, and behind it Hekau. The gods who tow the boat are called Tuayu. The sun's boat is met in this section by a company of 13 gods, who are under the direction of a god who holds a staff in his hand. The names of the first seven gods are Nepamenenha, Ba, Heru, Biha-Ea, Khnemu, and Set-Chet. The third has the head of a ram, and the fourth that of a hawk. The last six gods are described as gods who are in the entrances. The god who bears the staff has no name. On the right of the boat are 24 gods, the first 12 of whom are described as those who are at peace, the worshippers of Ra, and the second 12 as the righteous who are in the Tuat. On the left side of the boat of Ra is the god Tem, who is depicted in the form of an aged man, leaning heavily on a stick which he grasps in his right hand. For male beings who are lying prostrate on their backs, 20 male beings, with their backs bowed, and their arms tied together at their elbows behind their backs. The inert, and the 20 is the apostates of the Hall of Ra, who have blasphemed Ra upon the earth, who have invoked evils upon him that is in the egg, who have thrust aside the right, and have spoken words against Kuti. The boat of the sun has passed through the second division of the Tuat, arrives at the gateway which leads to the third division. This gateway is unlike the first, which has already been described, for its opening is protected by an outwork, similar to that which protects the door of a fortified building. The outwork is guarded by nine gods, in the form of mummies, who are described as the second company of the gods, and in this wall, which completely divides the second division from the third, is an opening, which leads to a corridor that runs between two walls, the tops of which are protected by rows of pointed stakes. At the entrance to the corridor stands a god, in mummied form, called Amaua, and at the exit is a similar god called Sekhabesnafunin. Each is said to extend his arms and hands to Ra. At each side of the angle, near the entrance to the corridor, is a serpent, who ejects flames from his mouth. The flame from the one sweeps along the corridor, at the end of which it is met by the flame from the other serpent which sweeps along the inside of the inner wall. The flames of these serpents are said to be for Ra. The gateway leading to the third division is called Septet Uauau, and the door thereof, which opens inwards, is guarded by the serpent standing on his tail, who is called Akabai and faces outwards. Along the middle of the third division, we see the boat of the sun being drawn along by four gods. As before, the god Ra stands in a shrine, similar to that already described, and his companions are Sa and Hekau. The rope by which the boat is towed along is fastened to the two ends of a very remarkable object, in the form of a long beam, each end of which terminates in a bull's head. And from the fact that the four gods who tow the boat are seen again at the other end of the beam-like object, with the towing rope in their hands, it is clear that the boat of Ra, and the god himself, were believed to pass through it, from one end to the other. The object is supported on the shoulders of eight gods, in mummied form, who are called bearers of the gods. At each end, immediately behind the bull's head, stands a bull, and at intervals seven gods, who are called the gods, who are within, are seated upon it. At the end of this division stand four mummied forms, with their elbows projecting, and their hands crossed on their breasts. On the right-hand side of this division of the Tuat, the boat of the sun passes 12 shrines, each of which has its doors thrown wide open, and so permits us to see a god in mummied form standing inside it. These gods are described as the holy gods who are in the Tuat. Along the front of the 12 shrines stretches an enormous serpent, the duty of which is to protect those who stand in them. Beyond the shrines is a long basin or lake of boiling water, with rounded ends, in which stand up to their waists 12 mummied gods, with blackheads, who either have white bodies or are arrayed in white apparel. In front of each god grows a large ear of wheat. These gods are described as the gods in the boiling lake. On the left of the path along which the boat of Ra passes in this division of the Tuat are two groups of beings. In the first of these we see the god Tem, in the form of an aged man, with bent shoulders, leaning upon a staff, coiled up before him in voluminous folds, with its head flat upon the ground, is the monster serpent Apep. Behind Apep stand nine men, with their arms hanging by their sides. These are called the Chacha who repulse Apepi. In the second group is Tem, in a similar attitude, and before he stands nine gods, each holding the symbol of life in the right hand, and the scepter in the left. The nine gods are called Nebukert, i.e., Lords of Destinies.
Watch us on YouTube and Facebook. Listen to our podcast and support us on Patreon. Thanks for stopping by. We thank you for your participation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, share, make comments. We love feedback.